Hello everyone, my name is Andy from Lunautico Astro, and I'd like to welcome you to the first video in a series featuring our flagship products. Today, we're going to have a look at the CloudWatcher and its companion, the Solo. This video is for anyone who is new to the CloudWatcher and would like to know what it is and what it can do for you. So, without further ado, let's get started. The CloudWatcher is a mini weather station specifically designed to meet the needs of modern astronomers and astrophotographers. It was introduced in 2008 and since then has been under continuous development with frequent software and hardware updates which have made the CloudWatcher our best-selling product. At the time of recording, the CloudWatcher is available in three versions. The basic version features a light sensor, an inbuilt rain sensor, an infrared sky temperature sensor, which is used to detect the presence of cloud and as a source of ambient temperature. Available as an optional addition, an atmospheric pressure and relative humidity sensor add further parameters to your CloudWatcher data. Instantly recognisable by the addition of a third socket, the Hydrian version allows the connection of an optional RG9 Hydrian range sensor. With this version, it's really important to note that there is no inbuilt range sensor. So please only choose this model if you are also purchasing or already own the RG9 sensor. An industrial grade anemometer is available as an option on all three models in the range, and we recommend it especially for users of remote observatories. Something that can be confusing to customers starting out with the CloudWatcher is what role the Solo plays and whether or not you need one. The Solo is a mini computer whose primary function is to display the CloudWatcher data on a web page accessible across the internet and independently of your observatory computer. It comes into its own if you operate a remote observatory where you may want to know what the weather is doing before deciding to power up your computer and start a session. We'll be looking at the setup of the CloudWatcher with and without the Solo in a later video. We've seen how the CloudWatcher interacts with the Solo, but how else can it be connected to your observatory equipment? Well, the answer is in two ways. When you order your CloudWatcher, you also choose a multifunction cable with a range of lengths up to 10 meters. Two wires in the cable provide a general purpose means of communicating if the weather is safe or unsafe. This simple binary signal can be connected either directly to the observatory roof motor or indirectly via our multifunction dragonfly switch to provide a means of closing the roof in the case of bad weather. Exactly how we determine the safe and unsafe states will be covered in a separate video when we look at the CloudWatcher software in detail. The safe-unsafe solution, while simple and effective, is really an emergency backup, since nowadays most of us work with intelligent imaging software that is capable of assessing the weather itself and making the decision whether to continue, end, or even restart a session based on weather information provided by the CloudWatcher. Once again, we'll see exactly how this works in a later video. The CloudWatcher comes with its own software, available in several formats, including Windows and Mac OS X. If you own the Solo, you may choose not to use the CloudWatcher software, as the Solo produces data files directly from the CloudWatcher that can be read by a number of operating systems and technologies. If you have a specific requirement, please get in touch with us and we can advise you of the best configuration for your needs. For most people, however, a Windows PC provides the simplest environment in which to use the CloudWatcher. We hope that you found this video useful. Please leave us some feedback below. In the next video, we'll look at how to set up the CloudWatcher and the various connection options. In the meantime, thank you for watching, and until next time, goodbye.